Hello everyone. So in this video tutorial, we'll learn about the Java swings. And Java swing is a very nice concept. If you learn Java swings, then you'll be able to understand why Java has so much demand in the market and why Java can be used for writing complex code in a very few lines of code. See this is just 15 lines of code we have in front of us. And in this code, what we are using java.swing package. So swing is a concept for the Windows-based application. If you run this program, you can see this kind of windows you are getting. Now just imagine that to get such kind of windows in C or C++ with a button, with the click and writing over here in this button, to get this shot of the window, how much lines of code and how much complexity you should supposed to go through in C or C++ to attain the same thing. The same thing we can attain in a very simple lines of code over here by using this Java swing. So let's start with the Java swing. This is a very important concept and a very good package in Java, which provides for the Windows-based application. It's a java.swing package. So what is a swing actually? It is used to create Windows-based applications. Windows-like application, if you wish to create, then you should supposed to use, you can use Java swings. It's platform independent also and lightweight components. It is built on top of the AWT. AWT you might have known if you have gone through with the basics of Java Windows applications. Then abstract windowing toolkit is a set of java.aw is a package which consists of set of classes and methods which is used for creating the Windows based application, right? On the top of the AWT, swing is developed. It has the API, application programming interfaces, means the methods which are available and required for Windows based application, and it is entirely written in Java. So there are lots of the important classes actually to explain really the swing, the entire package. It requires almost maybe 12 to 14 hours of video, but we just want to make the thing simple. So the main classes and the basic methods will be explained in this particular video, but I'll make you sure that the basics of the Java swings will be clear after watching this video. And this entire PDF of 50 long pages, you'll get it in front of you after watching the video, because the link will be provided to you. So java.swing package provides classes for Java swing API. We have important classes like jbutton, jtextfield, jtextarea, jRadioButton, jcheckbox, etc. As you can see that each and every class in swing API is started with the term j. Yes, j is provided before that. If you remove j, this button class may be available in the AWT package. So we'll just start with the swing. Before that, we'll just go through with the differences between AWT and swing. So AWT components are platform independent, but swing is platform independent. That's one of the advantage of swing. AWT components are heavyweight. It requires the entire process, but the processor weightness in operating system is less for Java swing. So it's a lightweight process. Pluggable look and feel doesn't supported by AWT. Pluggable look and feel is supported by swing. Less components are available in AWT than swing. And MVC architecture is not followed by AWT. It's a very, very important difference between the AWT and swing. MVC is the model view controller architecture. It represents that model will be data, view will be the presentation windows, and controller will act as an interface between this data and window. That is the view, and this view is the window, and the model is the data, right? So in between there, one specific layer is there. That layer is the layer is the controller. So controller will make sure that how the data will be accessed through that particular presentation or window. That is not supported by AWT, but that is supported by swing. So in this video tutorial, I'll show you all these MVC methods, okay, which is used in swing. So one each example for the classes. The main classes of swing will be explained to you, and then their MVC, that is the model view controller, that is upon doing something on the windows which will be open in front of you, what the next action can be taken, that will be explained to you. Okay, swing is JFC component also, na? JFC is Java Foundation Classes. It's a GUI components, graphical user interface component. Desktop applications can be created by using this GUI. Java swing is part of the JFC only for creating the Windows-based applications. How these Java swing classes are determined, how these Java swing classes are designed, the hierarchy of Java swing classes are this. In the top, we have the object class. Object class is the super class of all the classes, right? Next, we have a class known as the component, which has derived the object class into that. Now we are coming to the specific classes of Java Swing. So J component is a very important class in Java Swing that derived the component class. Now this J component class has been derived by all these classes, and these classes has a particular capacity. Like J level can be used for creating labels. J list can be used to create list of maneuvers. Correct? J table can be used to store the table structured data. J combo box can be used to create combo box in Windows. Combo box, you know, I'll show it, all these things. Okay. So in this way, the entire package has been created. Now container is derived by Windows and panel. Panel is derived by applet, and Windows is derived by what? Dialog and frame classes. So we'll go through with this main classes one by one. Before that, just a component class I'll go through, because component class is a very important class. Just before I told that this component class is very important class, and this is the swing specific component class which derived the component class. So the methods of component classes are very important actually. So we'll go through with that once. We have the public void add method, which pass the component object over here. It will add a component to the another component. Set size will set the size of the component in the height, width, etc. Public void layout will put the layout manager. It will set the layout manager. I'll show all these things one by one. And set visible will make it true or false. That is, we can either set the visibility or we may not show the visibility. So how to create a swing class? How to start with the swing? There are two ways to create a swing frame. Frame means the windows. By using java.swing package, we can create a Windows-based application, right? So Windows window frame can be created by two ways. By object of the frame class, by extending the frame class, anyone. Best way is that the most time we provide the inheritance capacity only. That is by inheriting the class frame. We don't create the object frame generally. But yes, we can create the object of the frame class if the java.swing package is imported, and then we can do our necessary things. So we'll go through with this first swing example right now. So this first swing example, you can see we have imported the javax.swing. Always swing package is the extension of Java, is the advanced Java part actually. It actually lies between the basic Java and advanced Java. And all the packages of the advanced Java over here starts with the javax. So always keep this thing in mind. If you just type java.swing, it will not work. It is javax.swing. Now we have created a class. What's the name of the class? First swing example. What the first swing example does? First swing example has a main method. Now we are creating an object of the JFrame class. Where the JFrame class is available in the swing package. We are not inheriting that. We are just creating the object of the JFrame class directly by using association property over here. Yes. JFrame class we are creating. Then JButton class object we are creating. See this? It's a JButton class. JButton class is resides into the java.swing package and used to create the instance of button. So a button will be created into the output screen, and it should be fit to the particular frame. Frame in the window. The name of the JButton is click. So in this button, the click will appear. Now we are setting the bounds. Bounds means axis, x axis, y axis is being set by first two arguments. Next two arguments will set the width and height of the window. Yes, where in the window this particular width and height of the button will be there, and in which x axis and y axis specific boundaries this button will display. That's being set. Now we have now the buttons and its property has been created by using the set bounds method, which resides into the package itself. Now we have to add this button to the frame. This frame is like the window, okay? So in this frame, we are adding this button. Now this frame is being now optimized. How we are optimizing? We are telling the size by using the set size method. We are telling that the width of the window will be 400 and 500 will be the height. Yes, we are not using any layout manager. It's the first program, right? So we are setting it null. And visibility we are making it true. If we make the visibility true, then only it will be displayed into the output screen. Now let me explain that. Now I have executed. So let me execute it. This, you can see that how the frame is being displayed over here. So this is the size 400 by 500. If I make it 600 by 500, then what will happen? And if I execute, see the difference between this frame and that frame. The last frame was 400 by 500. It is 600 by 500. So differences are being made. So you can understand that by setting the size of the frame, we can make the size large or small. Similarly, by setting the bounds also, it should supposed to know some things properly actually. Otherwise, the bounds will not work properly. Now the size of the button I try to increase. See this, the size of the button is increased. If I make it 100 by 80, then the size will be more than the previous. See this now. This size of the button and this size of the button is different, right? Yes, this x axis and y axis also we can change in this way. Now if I execute, you can see that the button will appear in a different position. See this, now it has come to the middle position because we are giving the changing the size to 230. In this way, you will get this program over there and then you can execute that and with the different values, and you can have the good understanding that where to put which particular values of JFrame. I mean, these values, how it operates and how it actually works, how it make differences. These values also, how it make differences. You will get the clear understanding if you go through with that. Similarly, you can put here false. If you put it false, then it will not be displayed. If you don't put it null, then you should supposed to add the layout managers. All these differences you have to check one by one. Now, this is the first swing program which you have learned. Yes. Now we'll see that how to create a swing now with association inside a constructor. Yes. So how to create a constructor inside that the object should be created. Otherwise, each and everything is same in this program. I'll open this program now. This is the program. I have created and written each and every program so that you can save the time and the video can be within lesser time. But we have so many classes to explain it to you. See here, the same thing has been explained. Same thing has been done over here. We are creating the instance as the reference variable of JFrame over here, and using the constructor of the class simple, we are creating the JFrame. Now here things are all same. Things are all same over here. But we are creating an object of the class by anonymous object we are creating, new simple. So it will call this constructor and the entire thing will be as like the last program. And this particular frame is created. This is another way of creating a Java swing. That's it, nothing else. Now we'll see a swing by inheritance. Now you see that in this program we are extending the JFrame. I told that swing can be created in two ways at the beginning. By association, which I have done in the last two programs, we have seen that we are creating the object through the JFrame object, and this is the next way is by inheritance, that is to extend the JFrame class. Now if you create the object of the simple2 class, then also it will work. So this is a simple2 class. Now you can see that we are using the inheritance over here. We are inheriting what? JFrame, which resides in this particular package. And in the constructor of the class simple2, we are creating the object of JButton and writing the name click and setting the same boundaries. Yes, and then adding this B. See this, any object name you are not specifying here. Just add B. Because it's a constructor, na? So constructor will be called by whom? By a object only. So whichever object will call this particular constructor, there on that particular object, we are binding this button. And that object should be the JFrame object because it extends that. Now each and everything is same like the last one. Set size, set layout, and set visibility, each and everything is same. So if you create it, then what will happen? The same sized window with a button with the same height and width and the size will be printed. This is the second way of creating a swing application. So you can understand the swing applications can be used for creating the Windows-based application, and it can use these two different methods. One is by association, that is without inheriting. We'll use the JFrame, we'll create the JFrame object, and using that we can create the swing applications, swing-based Windows applications. And we can do in the second way, that is by inheriting the JFrame class and doing the job done. Yes, now we'll go to the JButton, Java JButton. The Java JButton class is used for what purpose? To create a labeled button that has a platform independent implementation. How this JButton class resides is resides by inheriting the abstract button class. It has this particular constructors. If we are using this constructor, right? String S you are passing. So that name will be there on the button. Or you can part to the, we can also pass some icon. Yes, this icon is the object. That object will be displayed over there. What are the commonly used methods are there for the abstract button class? Set text, get text, set enabled, get icon, and their details are provided all over here. I'm not explaining it so that we can make the things know, in smaller time. You can just download the PDF after watching the video, and you can go through with these things. You will understand very easily. I'll go through with this program and explain. That will be better for you to understand this thing in lesser time. This action listener, I just want to explain. Add action listener will be used for action listening to the object. That is, if you click on button, then what action may be taken, that can be decided using this add action listener. It's a part of the event delegation model, MVC, model view controller architecture, that can be used by this particular thing. So J button example, I'll show it to you, then I'll explain to you line by line. See, this button example is here. So this button example, I'll explain it first. So what we're doing over here, we are using the JFrame, we are creating the JFrame name is button example. That will be the Windows name of the Windows will be button example. This is the constructor, single parameterized constructor of the JFrame class. Now we are creating a button with the object name B, and it will print over there, click here. This is the bounds we are setting, and we are adding this button to this particular frame, then setting the size of the frame and setting the layout, that is no layout, so null, and visibility is true, so it will be visible over there. See here, click here is being displayed. If you click here, then what will happen? Nothing, because no action listener is put. If I click, I'm clicking actually, nothing is happening, correct? Yes. So that's the first button example. I showed it without any complexity, very simple button example. Now we'll see another button example here. What you do in this button example, how it's different. See that something extra we are adding here, importing here, java.awt.event. So this particular package class, this particular package, Java package, under that sub package is AWT, under there is a sub package event. There we have many classes that consist of the capacity using the methods to implement the event delegation actually. So action performed whenever you will be using, I'll explain it to you, that time you have to use this particular package. So if we run over there, first I'll run and let you show it how it will differ with the last program. If you run, then what will happen first? See, it will create a completely different pack. Sorry, twice I clicked. So it will create completely different type of application. See the line number 26. Here it is giving the button example as the name of the window. That is like the last program only. Now we are creating a JF text field. See here. Text fill, J text fill is a class which is in the java.swing package. We are creating an object of that. Name of the text field is TF, which has, you know, a bound of 50, 50, 150, 20. That's why it is displaying in this particular location. You can change these bounds. There is the x-axis, y-axis, and their location. Then it will be positioning in some other place. Yes. So it is starting in the same vertical line. Na? So here it is 50. So here also we are making it 50, but here it is 50, here we are making the size as 150. So what will happen here? It will be double than that. Okay, that thing you can change and see it, how in different positions we can display this text fields. Now this text field is set the bound over here, and another button is created with the name click here. So that's why it is click here is printing over here, and their bound is this. In this particular location with this particular size, the button is created. Now the new thing you are learning over here is this particular thing. What's that? We are adding the action listeners. We are calling the action listener method by using the object button. So action listener is a method which there in event delegation over there. In action listener, there's a class. I'll not go into that details. That's a different concept actually. So I'm not going to that detail. So this method will add something that in this button, whenever we'll click, some action will be taken. Otherwise, before in the last program, we have seen that if you click on the button, nothing happens. Just the button is created. Now we want to make the button live. That is, the button should work and should do something. To make that, we should suppose to add the concept of event delegation. And this java.aw.event is a package which implements event delegation model. So we are adding this method, we are calling this method, and this method has an argument. What's the argument? We are creating the object of the action listener. Action listener is a class which is available in java.awt.event. After creation of the class on the object on the fly, we are calling this particular thing. What is that? Public void action performed. So we are overriding this action performed method, which takes as an argument action event object. So we have to simply override this method, which is available in action listener class. So how we are doing that? Text field dot set text welcome to Java point. We can write down anything over here that will be printed. So you can write down welcome to Academy of Fine Learning. So this, whatever you will write in this particular text field, that will be printed. After you do what? You'll do something in this particular button. That if you click on the button, then what will happen? This thing will be printed over there. That's how this thing has been planned. Now in this frame, we are adding this button, and in this frame, we are adding this text field also. Always remember that JFrame has add method to add each and every item onto this. If you don't add, then this button or frame will be of no use. These objects you have to add, button object and text field object, we have added to the frame. And we have set the size of the frame as 400 by 400. And this layout and set visibility you have seen before. So if I execute this program, then what will happen? This thing has been, if you click, then it's printing welcome to Java point. And now it is printing Academy of Fine Learning. So it was running before. That's why it is giving that particular thing. Now it is displaying Academy of Fine Learning. Why? Because we have given this particular thing. Welcome to Academy of Fine Learning. See? So this thing has been now useful. If you change it, welcome to nowhere, then welcome to nowhere will be printed. If I execute this, see, if we do something with the button, because when we'll click on the button, then action listener will be executed, and then action performed will be also executed. We are overriding this method now, and that thing will set the text. Set text is a method belongs to this particular package that will set the text to this particular text field. So click over there, welcome to nowhere is printed. In this way, we have understood that how to use action delegation model in Java dot where swing. So that thing is very nice feature available in Java swing, which makes the Java Windows based application live on, that you can do something with that. Here we are creating another button. By what? By creating the object of JFrame, and button example will be displayed at the top. Then icon.png, that is, we are taking the JButtons item from this particular PNG file. I don't have this PNG file available on my project, so it will not be displaying for sure. But if it is available over there, then the button will get this particular image over there. See, this button is having neither no name, no image. If you have any image, and if you save the image as icon.png, then that will be displayed over here. Yes, that's the only difference it makes from the last particular program to this particular program. Yes, that's the only differences we have between the last program and this program, just to show that how image can be used over there. So now JButton example is provided to you with the action listener also. This is the example with the action listener that is also provided to you. And this is to display image on the button. That is by using this particular line, we have done that. So that has been also shown to you. So if the icon.image has the register in this particular image, then this image will be displayed. That's what I tried to display, but the image I have not downloaded. If I download it, it will take time. So hope that you understood that, how it works basically. Now we'll go to the next class of Java.swing, that is JLabel class. JLabel class will create a label. Yes, and it has these constructors. JLabel, if you pass this string argument, that the label will be having this particular string name. If you pass this icon, then that particular image will be displayed over there. And if you have this string S icon and this horizontal alignment, then it will create a JLabel instance with the specified text will be there, image will be there, and the alignment will be there in horizontal level. The methods are getText method will get the text, setText methods, and all these text methods are there, which I'll go through one by one. So we'll open that label, this class. See this, how this JLabel works. You know about the label, right? If I execute that, I'll show it first to you. If you don't know what is label, it will be clear to you. This is the label, simple. Something will be just printed into the Windows based application. That's the label is actually. How we are creating? We are creating a JFrame object as usual. We are creating two instances of the JLabel, and we are creating the object by calling new JLabel. So we are creating the object of the new JLabel and using this constructor. First, single parameterized string, single string parameterized constructor, and that will be the thing which will be displayed. Where it will display? It will display in this particular location with this particular size. Always you have to use set bounds for that. You are seeing it from the first program, correct? So I'm not going to explain it again and again. So set bounds is also there. Set bounds will also display in L2 object in this particular location, in this particular size. It will be displayed into the output screen. So you are adding this L1 and L2 one by one into this frame and setting the frame size is 300 by 400. So it is displaying this particular example. If you make it 1000 by 1000, then it will be large definitely. 1000 by 300 means it will be, the width will be larger, but the height is same. Hope that you understood all these concepts of J level. Now we'll go to in detail actually. This is a basic thing, na? This thing. That's why I'm not giving much time on this. I'll now go to this particular program. Now, what you're doing over here, this J label, this particular class, which extends the frame class and implements action listener. Implements means action listener is what? It's a particular interface. Sorry, I was telling you it's a class. It's an interface in java.awd.event. Nah? So it implements this particular interface. So this interface is used for listening the actions, whatever happens to a particular things. Here we'll show about the label and then it will react. So it will show it that suppose there is a button and if you put the button to this action listener, then the button will be live, like it can response things and all. And based on the response, you can suppose the someone clicked the button, then you can determine and you can specify the action for that. So we are having this particular example now. So level example constructor is called, we are creating a text field. Text field's bound is this set now. Now we're creating a label and the labels bounds are set over here. Now we're creating a button with the name find IP. And then you are finding setting the bound over here for this particular button. And then we are adding the action listener to where? Not to the text field, not to the label, but to the object B, that is the to the button. Now we are adding the button, text field and the label to this frame. Yes, and setting size of the frame and layout and visibility you have made. Now, we will create the object on the fly of the label example, one JFrame will be created and all these things will be created, right? But whenever we'll click on the button, then as we have added the action listener to it, we have called the action listener and passing the current object, then this particular lines of the code will be executed. Then what we'll do over here, it is getting the host by using the get text. From the text field, we are getting the text, whatever in the text field and storing in the string host. And IP we are determining, how we are getting the IP of this particular system. We are getting the IP by using this particular strategy, by using java.net.inetAddress.getByNameHost and get host address. Are you clear? In this way we determine the IP. So I'm not going in detail about the java.net and all these things, it will make you confused. So just IP will have the IP of this particular system, of my system. Now set text. Set text IP of host is IP. So where we are setting the test? In this label object L. Yes, correct. So a label will be displayed in the output screen. There the IP address will be printed. See this. If you click on the button, correct? See, action listener is added in line number 38 in the button only. So if you click on this, then only this action format will be printed and it will print over here the IP of this particular computer, 127.0.0.1. Yes. See this. I can type into the chat box also. Text box, sorry. Oh, many things has been explained or what? So in this way, we can program using the swing. We can provide the accelerations. This way we can create the labels. We showed how to create the labels over there, right? Now we'll go to the next class. So action listener, how JLabel object can be, those labels can be used with the action listeners. I have shown in the button we put the action listener and from there we are printing by using a label. Now we'll see the next class, JTextField. It will be used for creating the text fields. Already you have seen, right? Text fields. So it has many constructors and many methods which will be used for creating objects and calling up doing particular job by using the methods. So we'll go through with the text field. What is the text field? This is the text field class example.
So I'll remove these and we'll go through with this example now. So JFrame object we have created with the name text fill example, and text fills are created T1 and T2. So T1 is having a new text fill with the name welcome to Java Client and welcome to Swing will write. Swing text field. And then we are setting the bound of this particular text field. Then we are creating another text field with AWT tutorial. It is a swing tutorial. It is a text field tutorial basically. So now we are setting the bound to this and then we are adding T1 and T2 to the frame, then setting the size and executing. So it is a very simple program for you because you have already seen about the text field actually. See this now. Welcome to Swing and text field tutorial is being printed in this particular two text fields. Yes, so this is nothing new to you. It's very easy for you to grasp. Now we'll go to the next program. Here what we are doing basically, here in this particular example, we are implementing action listener. So for that we are creating two buttons and three text fields. The first text field is having no value, second text field has no value, third text field also has no values. You are not passing anything into the constructor, correct? But just we have just set the bounds over there, and set editable we make as false. So this method, set editable method of the text field, if you pass this false, means on that particular text field you cannot edit anything. Now J button is created. What button? Button name is plus, and we have set the bound over here. Now another button is created minus, and you have set the bound over there. So two plus and minus will be there, na? The sign will be displayed in the button. Now for B1 we have also added the action listener, for B2 also we have added the action listeners. In this line we are just adding these text fields, three text fields and two buttons in the frame, and here the frame's size is being set. Now action performed will be called whenever we'll click on this particular button 1 or button 2. So whenever we'll click on the button 1, then also the same thing will happen, same lines of code will be executed, and if you click onto the button B2, then also the same lines of the code will be executed. What you're doing basically, from the text field 1 we're getting the text, whatever the things are written and printed into the text field 1, that thing we are getting and storing into the string S1 and string S2 for the text field 2, correct? And then we are parsing to the integer. See, the values are by default, the values of the text fields are string considered in Java, that is being converted to integer values by integer.parsing method. So integer is a wrapper class and parsing is a method over there to convert a string value to the integer value. So integer A and B we got, integer C is set to 0. Now if E.getSource is equals to B1, are you getting? That is, if we are clicking on B1, it means that E is what? Action event. Action event, whenever you click on the button, one object will be created. The object is determined as E. E.getSource, that where from the object is being generated. If it is equals to B1, that is if you click on the button B1, then we are adding it, because B1 is adding, right? B1 will display plus now, so we'll add it. So A plus B is being displayed. And if it is minus, that is B2, then we are doing it subtraction between A and B. And then the result will be printed by converting to the string. So C will be an integer, right? That will be converted to string by string.value of method. Value of method is a method which resides in the string class, which will convert to the string result, and that is being displayed into the text field 3. So whenever we'll executing this new object, it will go over there and it will display this particular thing into the output screen. So it's a very nice example for you. You are seeing now how the application of Windows actually possible in this particular example. So this thing we have made as non-editable. See, this text field 3 is non-editable, right? See, set editable is false for TF3. So we cannot edit anything. In here and here, you can give some value. Text field 1 and text field 2, you can give some value. I'll give 10 and 5. So text field 1 and text field 2 got values 10 and 5. That will be, if you click on the plus button, then this and this will be added and it will be displayed on this particular 15. And if you click on minus, 10 minus 5 will be given and result will be 5. Yes, all these things are happening because you are clicking, when you are clicking, these particular lines of the codes are being executed, and I explained you how this particular lines of the code works. well, so I'll comment this now. So you have seen now with text field how to work with the action listener also, how text fields can be used interactively by using the buttons. So these methods and all these things you can just go through one by one. I'll share the PDF, right? So we'll go through with these things programs. These programs are explained to you right now. Go with 3, I have explained it to you also. These lines of code also I have explained each and everything line by line. So if you don't understand, just go back and try to understand the thing. Now we'll go through the next class. We'll learn the next class, JTextArea class. Yes, JTextArea is a multi-region will display in the text. Okay, I'll just show you with the particular example only. TextArea is very interesting. This is the TextArea, right? If I execute this particular code, what will happen? Now the entire code is displayed in front of you, or some lines. Yeah. Now the entire program is shown to you, na? So this program will execute what? See this. This is the TextArea. You can write down anything. I'm just typing, huh? This thing I'm typing. TextArea it is. It is not text field. Text field is a small place. TextArea is a bigger place. So we are creating a JFrame object within the new JFrame. JTextArea area object we have created, new JTextArea, and we are writing in the bracket welcome. And in this area, we are setting the bound with this bound 1030, 200, 200. So this is the size. Yes, and this is the X and Y locations where the particular thing has been, you know, the particular area will be displayed into the frame. Now we are adding the area, text area to the frame and setting the frame size 300 by 300. Well, so if you're creating the object of text area example, then that will be executed, and what will happen? It will in turn display this particular text area as I've shown it to you. See this. So this is a 200 by 200 size. This is a 300 by 300 size. This JFrame. Yes. The text area example only, right? Text area example is now displaying on the top of the frame. Well, we'll go to the next. Here we'll show you how action listeners can be used. How action listeners can be used. Is it completely displaying to you? I hope yes. So I'll show you here how action listeners can be used in text area example. So two labels we have created, one text area we have created and one J button we have created. So we have created these labels and areas and buttons and set the bounds over here, correct? And the button name is count words. Now action listener is put to the button. Now all this label, area and button is added to the frame and the frame size is set. Now we'll go through the action performed, this part. What we're doing actually, from the area, text area, area is an object of what? JTextArea, na? So from this particular object, we are getting the text, whatever is written over there. It is being stored into the string text. Next, this text is split by back front slash s. Yes, I'll show you how it happens. Then we are storing it to the array of words. Yes, now the words length we are displaying, and then characters length we are getting from the text, and it is being displayed using the L1 and L2 labels. So into the output screen, two labels will be there, L1 and L2. That will be just print the same thing into the particular line. I'm writing hello all, how you? How many words are there? 4 words. How many characters are there? 18. How you are getting this? This is what we are getting by using this splitting by space. So whenever there is space is there, it is being split. So after hello, there is a space. So it is taken as a single word. After all, there is a space or line, correct? So then it is taken as a separate word. And how, after how there is a space, so it is taken as a separate word. And after you, there is space, nothing you are writing. So it will be taken as a space, and then you will be considered as a word. So how many words are there? 4. How many characters are there? 18. How many characters? 18 characters are there. So you are displaying it. 18 is being displayed over there. Characters. Text dot length. So entire text, their length is being taken and their character is being printed by using the, this is the label 1. Words are displayed. Words 4 is displayed by label 1 and characters 18 is being displayed by L2. Yes, and if you type something else, then it will be definitely changing the values. In this way, the Windows-based application you have created using Java. Well, so the text area is also over to you. Now, these programs are also explained in front of you. Yes. Now we'll see about the J password password field. How this password field actually works. Password fields, you know, for the password field, what you do, it's like a text area only, or it's like a text field only basically. But in the text field, whenever you type the password, we show it by using asterisks. We don't want to show the password to the entire users. Correct? Now users only by heart the password and that's being shown. So password class has the similar constructors and methods. We'll show you the password field and their program. See this password? Yes. So this is the example of the password field. So the class is there. In this class, inside the main method, we have created the JFrame object and the name of the JFrame is password field example. We are creating a label and they are setting their bound. Then we are creating J password field object. The new thing is this line only, line number 28. So J password field object is value. And we're setting the values bound over here. Now L1 will be displayed username, L2 will display password. Now the button will be named login. It will be named as login. And then we've set the bounds definitely. Now in the text field, text, we are creating a text field. And this is the bound. Now we are adding all these text fields and labels and password field, each and everything into the frame and setting the frame size over here. Then setting the layouts and all other things. Now this part is very important. What you are doing over here, whenever you are clicking on the button, you have added the action to the button, right? So whenever you are clicking onto the button, then what's happening? It will go to the action event. This object will be generated, E. Correct? And what we are doing basically, this particular thing. I'll just make it big in front of you. Now you can see everything like in this line. So what's happening over here, string data is equals to username and text dot get text. So whatever you are writing in the text field, text, that is being taken. Now data is equals to data plus space password is new string value dot get password. So value of the get password from the value, where the value is. The value is in the J password field object, right? So this value is being derived, the get password. Get password, and then in the label we are setting the data. This data will be displayed by the label. What is the label? Label is nothing but this particular J label object. So you are displaying the data by using this label object, by using the setText method. So if you execute this, and what will happen? It will be displayed. It will ask for the username and password. Username is suppose TanV, and you can give some complex name, na? 10 super password is 10 T is capital TAN underscore super. So if you click on login, then what will happen? The password is displaying in this way. See this? Even if you large, can you see? Password is being displayed. If you make the password small, see this password is given as dot dot only. Yes, if you make CSE and password is also CSE, and if you click, see this password is displaying because it is coming into this particular space, because you are getting the value right here. You are getting the get password, now the getting the password now from the password object password field example now. J password field object we are creating the value, and from there we are getting the password. So if it is small only, then only on that particular label space it is being displayed. On this label bound it is displayed, otherwise not. This label bound should be enlarged enough. It should not be 50. it should be 200. Then only it have the enough space to display bigger passwords. Otherwise, see here now, if I write down big username now and big password here, and if I click, then I was okay, the password is very small. Actually, this button is very small over there, that's why it is not displaying. Otherwise, it has the capacity to display the password. So anyhow, you have understood that how to create the passwords which will be displaying you with the asterisk, with the blind feature. It will not give you the entire and clear concept of what you are typing. It will not give the correct value to you. CSEN 123. So it is, when you are clicking on the login, it is being displayed. Otherwise, it will not display. It is giving you like this. So that's the new thing you're learning over here, correct? So this is the password field in Swing example. Now we'll see the next thing. Next class, radio button. It's also very important, radio button. Radio button will do what? Radio button will do a very simple thing basically. Radio button will create radio buttons and you can click. Unless until you put any particular, you know, action listener, it will not work much. It will just display it to you. So radio button examples I'll display to you, and then it will be clear to you. Radio button examples. See, the entire programs I have written so that time can be saved. Still, as the Swing is a very large package and I'm showing you many live programs, it is still taking much time. So please be hold. Have your patience. So radio button examples, we have created the radio version, this particular class constructor. There we are creating the object of the JFrame, and we are creating two radio button. A is male and B is female. Radio button is like that, it will have the many options, and setting the bound of R1 and R2 radio buttons. Then button grouping we must actually. So all this button, one group should be there, because what happens in a radio button is that multiple options will be there. Suppose for color, four colors are there: red, green, blue, orange. So you can choose any one only. You can, it's not a checkbox, it's radio button. For checkbox, you can choose more than one colors. But for radio button, you can choose only one button. So here you can choose either male or female. So one button group should be there. On that button group, you should supposed to specify similar type of values. So button group is created. Button group is created by button group object. Class object, right? That is in java.swing package only. Now you have to add these radio buttons to this particular button group. Yes, and we are adding this particular R1 and R2 radio buttons to this particular frame after that, and setting the size of the frame, and all these things are the all same. We are creating the object over there and the radio buttons will be created over there. So it cannot do anything. Keep this thing in mind, because we are not using any action listener, so it cannot do anything. Just two buttons will be created, and if you click, nothing else will happen. But you understood that how radio buttons are, right? Male or female, these options are coming. So I'll comment this particular lines of code, rather I'll go with another code which will be having action listeners, so that the radio buttons can be of any use. So what's happening over here? See, it's a very nice example. It's extending JFrame and implementing action listener also. So two radio buttons are created, RB1, RB2, and button is created as B. We have the constructor over here, and the first radio button is the male, and we are setting and displaying in this particular location with this particular size into the frame, male, and second one is female, correct? Now the same thing, these things are all same, right? Now one button is created. This part is same like the last program. Just some syntactical differences are there, but the conceptual similarity is all 100% similar. But here from we are doing something else. What we're doing, a new button is created with the name click, and this is the bound for this button, and we are adding the action listener to this button. Now all the things, radio buttons and the button are added to the frame, and the size is set over here. And now the action perform will be created whenever we'll click on this button, click, named click. The button named is click. When we'll click on this button, this action perform will be called. What the action perform will do? It will check that if the first one is radio button one is selected. Is selected is the method which will check that which particular radio button is being clicked on. If we click on this particular first radio button with the value male, then it will print into the output screen what? You are male. You are doing it by using J option pane. On that class, J option pane is a class which will display the message by using show message dialog method. Similarly, if you click on the next radio button, then what will happen? It will print in the output screen you are female, using the same methodology. So you are calling the object, you are creating an object on the fly, and then this particular things will be implemented into the output screen. Male or female, if you click on male and click, then it will display in a new J option pane. What will display? You are male. If you click OK, it will go out. Are you clear? This how you should supposed to learn the program. You have to change the program, you have to modify the program, and in this way you have to learn the program out. Got it? If you click on female and if you click on click, then it will just create another J option pane and it will print over here you are female. Yes, if you click over here, it's gone. Like that, it will be creating one by one. Got it, right? So this is how the things will be created. Now we'll go to the next example. J radio button is explained to you. Now we'll go to the J combo box. It's also a very nice example. J combo box will provide you the combo box. See, this J combo box is creating with the combo box examples. How it will do? We'll creating the constructor over here. We are creating the object, and the combo box will be having the values of these countries. Yes, and passing this array into the new combo box. Setting the combo box over here, adding the combo box to the frame, and each and everything is same like the last program. So if you execute over here, the combo box will display. Combo box means, you know, right? A list. A list will be pop up. See, this is the combo box. So if you click on anything, nothing else will happen because there is no action listeners added. So I'll just comment this particular line and display this. See this now. This particular example, what will do? If you execute, then what will happen? The same thing is there. See, the languages are there here displaying, correct? But we are having a add listener to the button B. What is the button B? The button B is this. This button is having the name show. Yes, this is the horizontal alignment we are doing in the level. So then what will happen? It will display to this particular things here. So if I execute that, you can see the differences. J action listener will be called, and there this data will be printed. Programming language selected, and this particular things will be selected. It will be printed by using this label. So if you select Java and click on show, it will display over here. Programming language selected Java. By using the label, it is setting the text by using the data. This data will be created by this particular object over here. Are you clear? This data is created. So you have to learn this thing by changing, okay? You cannot learn simply by sticking to a single point. You have to keep on adding that, change this string, change these strings, and change this, set bounds and all other methods, and use the different methods if required. And in this way, you can keep on experimenting. Then you'll get the clear understanding that how the different things are happening. So if you execute with the new values will be popped up. Suppose this array values you are changing, then this here the new values will be generated. And then if you click on show, then if you don't want to use label, if you use the J option pane, then it will create a new dialog box. This particular thing will be printed into the new dialog box, and all these things you can check it out one by one that I've given to you. This is a J combo box. So void add items, void remove items, and all these things will be used for that. Yes, guys. So this is how it works. Now we'll go through the J table. J table is another class. J table is another class which is used for displaying the table values. I'll just show you the program. You can understand better than the theoretical parts. So this table examples will give you the clear understanding of how these tables can be used and how much capacity these tables has actually in Java program. So you have created the these lines are all same to you. We have this particular data, right? This is the particular data we have. It's the key value pair. This is the first row, this is the second row, and this is the third row values. Okay, and the column values are ID, name, and salary. We're defining into two arrays. Two dimensional array it is a single dimensional array. ID, name, and salary, and these are the values we have. Now we are creating an object of the J table. You can see this in the new thing you're learning using the data and column, both the values. So data will be having one value and the column will be having another value. Correct? Data is having this particular 2D values because 2D array it is na. And this column is having a 1D array, okay, because it will just it will display on the top ID, name, and salary. Now we are setting the bound of this particular J table object. Now J scroll pane we can use the J scroll pane. I'll show you how it works actually. Here scroll pane will make you to scroll the things. And then we are just creating the object over here. Then these things will be executed. And this particular table will be displayed in front of you, and you can scroll it also. See, you can scroll in this way, JS scroll pane. This is the ID, name and salary. It looks like a table, right? It looks like a full-fledged table, correct? Yes, it's showing a full-fledged table to you now in this particular frame, ID, name and salary. So whatever you will pass in the second argument, that will be the on the top as a column, and whatever the value will pass as the first argument in the object of JTable, in the constructor of JTable, two parameterized constructor, that will be printed over here as the values over here. This is how it has been defined. Yes, are you clear? So in this way it is being displayed. So now we'll change this and we'll add some action listeners to make the things more fun. See here, we have added that action listeners now. So what we're doing basically here, okay, you cannot see the program, I think. We'll change it here. Yes. And change it here. Yes. Now I hope that you can see the entire program. So these things are being displayed over here. Well, so this frame is created with the name table example. What's happening? Okay, so if I execute this, you can see this particular example. Now if I click over there, then it is displaying over here the same thing. See this element select is 101. If you click 1, then it will display over here 101. See this, it is displaying 102 and 101. So whatever you are selecting over here, that is being printed there. But here there is no button, see here. But for J it is element. For Amit also it's there. Now I'll show it to you. First let me show you that this is a table example as the frame name, and we have the data 101 Amit 67,000 with the ID, name and salary. Yes. See here it is actually missing. So you have to bring it here. So these are the values which are displaying being here. 101, 102 and 101 Sachin 70,000 salary. So this is being displayed by that. Now this is the second column value, and we have created the same way we created the JTable in the last example. This part is same to you, right? So just cell selection enabled true. So set, we can select any one of the cell because we have made it as true over here. Now list selection model object name is select. This is another class, and get selection model, we are calling it this method, and it will get the selection. Now select dot, that is this object we are using, set select mode, this selection mode, that particular method is used for list selection model, and its operator single selection is now enabled with that select. Now we are doing the main thing over here, add list selection listener. So how to selection listener will be happening by using creation of this particular list selection listener. So list selection listener is this particular interface which you are using over here. Now this thing is completely new to you. Here we are creating public void value changed. So this particular abstract class we have to override. It will also have list selection events object. Yes, not action listener object, because it's a table. Now we require this particular classes. Now we are doing this particular job over here. The data is null first, then rows, we are getting the selected rows and storing into the value row. Now into the column you are getting. Now integer I and integer j is used for two for loops so that we can go through the entire table. And the data is converted to the string data from these particular values, row I and column j. So one by one we can get it, correct? And then table element selected is data is being printed into the output screen. Now j scroll pane is also used over there so that you can scroll over there, adding the frame, adding, setting the size of the frame and setting the visibility of the frame. Those things are being done to you. So if you select all these things, see this scrolling is possible, correct? Whatever the things you'll do, that is being printed over there because we have added this action listener. See this. Sorry, I have to see it, show you properly. See this. See. Correct, it's being displayed. That's what we wanted to do, right? Yes, that's what we are not to do, huh? Table element selected is we are printing over there while we are doing system.out.println. So it will be displayed into the output screen here in the console. That's how the program is being made. You can use the J option pane, then whatever the things will select, a new windows will be created, and that will be this particular things will be printed over there on this window. But that will make lots of the windows will be created whenever you will select. So we have make it to print over here in the console itself. This is the example of table, how to create J tables and how to add up with the action listeners. So here the, as you seen for table, the action listener is different. We cannot use the same action listeners everywhere. Yes. So here we require what? List selection listener. This particular set selection mode, add list selection listener, all are the list selection listener, you know, constructor. All these things are belongs to the list selection listener classes matters. All these things are related to list selection listener. So you have to use this particular class for action listening. Now we have the JList. JList is very simple thing actually. It is a list of values. I have the program also here. This is a JList example. Yes. So you can see that we are creating the items, four items, using the labels. Now these four labels are put into a list of generic type of string. So this list is created and the bounds are set. Now we are adding the list to the frame, setting the size and layout over here. So it's a very simple thing that I can understand that a list can be generated from a label. See this, it's a list. These are all grouped actually to a list. Item 1, item 2, item 3 and item 4, all are what? Listed using what? A list. Name of the list is list only. It should be the object of the JList class. It's a very simple program. You have understood that the labels can be used to group by using the JList class object. Now we'll see that how action listeners can be used for this particular example also. The problem with that is, okay, if I make it finalize, it's all good. Now I think you can display entire thing in your screen. Yes, this thing is not displaying. Okay, it can be understood if you watch properly. See. So list class, a list example is the constructor over here, and we're creating the JFrame object F and JLabel object. We are creating label and we're setting the size 500 by 100. J button is B, new J button show, and we are setting the bound over here. And default list model L1 we are creating. See, so list you have seen in the last class JList. Now we are seeing default list model class. Yes, it's a generic class of the type string. L1 can hold many string values. Now you are adding the elements in this way by using add element. So no need to create 1, 2, 3, 4 different labels. Correct. In this list, directly you can add these labels, C++, Java and PHP. And then you can put this particular L1 to to the list by using the JList class object. So list one is the object of the JList class, which is the type of the string generics, so it can hold string values, and then we are just passing the L1 over there. As simple as that. As simple as that now here. Now we are passing what? List1.setBounds. We are setting the bounds 100, 100, 75 and 75. And default list model we are sending. How? By using the default list models constructor. And we are passing what? Turbo C++, Frats, Spring and YYY. Yes, so we are actually matching with this particular to this particular. And we are creating within the same method of JList object. List2, passing the L2 as an L2 as an object to the constructor of the JList class. Now we are adding each and everything as we do it generally. Now we are putting the add action listener over here to the button. What's the name of the button? Button is show. Show button will do what? It will take this one data string as taken as null over here. Now get selected list if it is not equals to -1, that is if something has been selected, then you are printing programming language selected is from the list one. You are getting the get selected value. So list one na, get selected, this is in the list one na. Let me show you again this thing in the list one, correct? What is that list one here? These four examples are into the list one because we are passing L1, which has C++, Java and PHP into L1, list one. And in the list 2, we have these four values because it's in L2.addElement we have done. Turbo C++, struct, sprint and YYY. So these things are being displayed over here, correct? Programming language selected, list1.getSelectedValue and label.setTextData. So setTextData will be print into the this particular label. The same thing is done for frameOxSelected we are printing. And then you are printing into the output screen. This is a deprecated method actually, that's why Java compiler is displaying like this. Deprecated, yes, but doesn't matter, it will work for sure. So we are getting from the each object and will be displaying over here. Then label.setTextData, again we are setting the another data. See here, so 2L1 and L2. We have generated list 1 and list 2. Now if you select Java and struts and if we click on show, then what will display? If you selected Java and struts from the list 1 and list 2. So what will display? It will display from L1 and L2 is selected na? See, from L1 is selected, it will display programming language selected and this particular value, list1.getSelectedValue. So programming language selected Java should supposed to display by this level. Somewhere in the here it should supposed to display, correct? Yes. And list 2, if the get selected index is not equals to -1, that is from the list 2, from there it will also check and it will print that data, that is programming language selected Java comma framework selected, and from there it will select the framework. So it will print in the output screen programming language selected Java comma framework selected and this particular framework struts. Programming language selected Java and framework selected struts, that's being printed. So you do some changes over there in these lines of code and see that how your output differs. So in this way you can learn it in a better way. I'll close these apps. Yeah. So JList is very important and very interesting, correct? So you've seen that how it basically works, how these things is being explained. That you can understand very clearly. Now J option pane, one example I'd show you already. So I'll just go through with another two examples and complete this particular tutorial. So please be patient a bit. Option pane. Yes, this class is there. See here, if I execute this option pane will generate now. It will create a new. Now it can display it into the screen, right? So it will print into a new dialog box. Hello, welcome. See this? Oh my God. It's not being executed till now. Hello, welcome. So new dialog box is created, right? To create this kind of dialog box or warning messages kind of thing, then we can use what? J option pane and subject. The J option pane is the class name, and this is its static method. You can call it by using the J option pane name and show message dialog directly, and whatever things will pass in this particular frame, if that will be printed. As simple as that. It's like a damn simple program, right? If you know the static method and keyword, then you can understand this program. As simple as that. Now, here we are doing that, successfully updated, and then alert, and this alert message, see, warning message. So how it differs from the last program, if I execute here, you can understand very easily. See, successfully updated. Okay, warning message it is. So warning message is displayed over there. It's also a damn simple program. Now we'll see that show input dialog, how it works. How the show input dialog works. Different methods we have to do different jobs. See. Done. Yes, you have seen that, how string name is taken as, if you can print the name also, J option pane dot show input dialog, enter name, that is being printed over there. Now we see the next method, show confirm dialog. See this, add window listeners also we have added. The window closing is the name of the abstract class. When the windows is closing, are you sure will be printed by using the J option pane. It will create a confirm dialog. By using the show confirm dialog, a new warning message will be displayed. Yes, and you can use yes option on exit on close. Set default close operation method you can call for that. See this, nothing is displaying, right? If you click on this close button, then what will happen? It will call on the add windows listener. And the public void windows closing will be called with the windows event object E. Are you clear? And it will create a J option pane by using this line, line number 67. It will create a confirm dialog, confirm message. That is, are you sure it is being displayed? See, if you click no, then it will not be gone out. If you click on a yes, then it will exit on close. We are specifying these things. Yes. Such a simple thing, such a big things, which you can't do in a simple way in C or C++, can be done so easily using Java. This is what you are learning over here. Correct. So this message is being explained in front of you. Now we'll go through with the last example of J scrollbar. The last class we'll learn today is J scrollbar, how the J scrollbar actually works. And it's a very interesting concept also. Scrollbar example is here. How it will work? It will create a scrollbar. You can scroll through the windows. It's very simple. Just J scrollbar object you have to create. You have to set the bound and add to the frame. Set to the size. Then you the windows which will generate, that you can scroll. That's it. See this, you can scroll. Only that thing, nothing else. Other than that, each and everything is same over here. See? Just you can scroll over here by setting the bounds. That's it, nothing else. The program is all same to the any other swing programs. So now we have this particular examples. What are the examples we have? We are creating a label and setting the horizontal alignment to the center, setting the size this, and scrollbar object we are creating. Correct? Yes. For set scrollbar, if you add, then you have to add the adjustment listener. That is how the adjustment will be done. Adjustment listener interface is there, correct? Adjustment listener. So now it will, we have to override this adjustment value changed method with the object will be passed as adjustment event object. And you are setting the text over there by using the label object, vertical scrollable value is s.getValue. So value will be displayed from 0 to 90. Yes, and you are creating the object. So from 0 to 90, keep this thing in mind. 0 to 90, the values will be keep on printing to the output screen. See this, now the same object is created, right? Just one thing you've done is that we put the action listener over here. What the action listener over here? The name of the action listener is add adjustment listener. And we have overridden the method adjustment value changed. So if you click over there, the value will be printed by using this label. Line number 39 is doing this particular thing. And if you drag it, percentage will be increased. See this? 90%. Yes, the vertical scroll bar value will be printed in this way. It's so fun, na? It can be done in so complex, with so complexity by using C or C++ programming languages, which you can do in so easily in Java. So this particular thing is doing all these things. This particular action listener is doing all this. I mean, the event delegation model implementation is doing all these things. Not action listener, basically. We use the term action listener because we have habituated with that. It's event delegation model which is being implemented over there. So in this way, the Java Swing will make value to your life. It will make your programming very easy. So all these programs are explained to you. These are the basic classes of java.swing package. Now we have the last class, actually jmenubar, jmenu and jmenuitem. It will create the menus actually to your program. So I thought that was the last program. No, I think I have the menubar program or not. I have to see menu examples I have. Okay, this is the last program, and then you can we can close this session. The swing package is large package, right? So I'm taking more time to this particular program and I cannot skip anything. See here, and this what we are doing, we are creating menu bar. Jmenu item is the menu bar object we have to create first, and then jmenu item objects will create. See, item 1, item 2, item 3. Now this item objects i1, i2, i3 all will be added to the menu. Menu is an object of the jmenu class. Yes, now we have added this all items to the jmenu class. Now we have the submenu. Submenu for what? i4 and i5. This submenu is added to the menu also. It's very nice, right? The menu will be generated. Like you go for the Windows, now we have a menu. You click over there, drop down button will come, like many options will come. From there, we can, if you keep your mouse over there, many other menus will be generated. That thing is being implemented over here. Then MB is what? Menu bar. In this menu bar, you are adding this menu. So there is a menu bar. There is a menu bar. Okay. Over there, many menus are there. One of the menu has the sub items, sub menu bars. That's what being implemented over here. See this? This is the J menu bar is added to the frame, and the size is been done. We're just creating an object on the fly. So I hope that you understood. One menu bar we have created, correct? This is the J frame. Okay. In the top, it will print menu and menu item example. So first, we have created menu bar. On that menu bar, we have added the menu. Yes, these are the menu items we have added. In the menu, all these items are added. Now we have a submenu, that is i4 and i5. These are the submenu. Submenu will be added to the menu. Yes, and this menu will be added to the menu bar. So menu bar, menu, submenu. This is how the hierarchy is being maintained. Yes, hope that it understood it. Okay, I'll execute this and it will be clear to you. If I'm not yet understood, if I just generate an example, see this now. This is the menu bar. This is what? It's the menu bar. If I click, menus are generated. Item 1, item 3, item 1, 2, and 3. These are the menus. Now we have a submenu. This is a submenu, right? We are printing submenu, correct? By using this jmenu object, another jmenu object, the name we have given as submenu. In the submenu, we are adding i4 and i5. i4 and i5 is item 4 and item 5. So if you click on submenu, item 4 and item 5 should supposed to display. Item 4 and item 5 display. If you click, nothing else, nothing will happen, because no event delegation model is added, no action listener is added over here. Nothing can be done. Just I'm displaying this menu bar with the name menu, and if you click, we have these menus, these four other menus, and this menu has two submenus. That's it. That's it over here. Now if you want to add some action listener, I mean if you do something, then it will be nice, right? It will be showing you more capacity. So you are implementing the action listener over here. So at the end, I'll remove the section comment. So what you're doing basically, action listener is having the menu bar, and then menu items. We have cut, copy, paste, select all the name. These are the objects, the same object name, actually items are created. See, menu items with the same names are created, so that these objects also will be very much significant and easy to understand for you. So add action listener, this, add action listener, this, add action listener, this, add action listener, this is created, selected all. Correct. And this file, edit and help are all the added to edit and edit and is added to the this files and edit and help is added to the menu bar. And the text bar, text array is also created. There the set bounds are created and we have added to the frame menu bar and text area both. And menu bar is also added after that. Yes, and if the action performance, even if any, if you make any click on the cut, whenever we'll click on there, what will happen? This particular object will be generated, na? So E dot, where you have put that action performed, it's very important to see, na? So action listeners are added over here in this particular thing. Cut, copy, paste, and select. What is cut, copy, paste, select all? These are the J menu item ID. J menu item class object. So whenever J menu item class object will click on the cut, then text area dot cut will, cut method will be called, then the paste method will be called, copy method will be called, select all method will be called, and all these things will be happening. I'll just show you with the example, running the this particular example, then it will be 100% clear to you. See this now. This is the menu bar is created. In this menu bar, we have this menu, file, edit, help. In the edit, we have added all these options. Only in the edit, we have added options, right? See, only in the edit we have added this cut, edit only you have added copy, in edit only you have added paste, in edit only you have added select all. We have not added anything in file or help, correct? In the file or help, we have not added anything. So nothing is displayed into the file and help. In the edit is displayed. If you click on copy, then it will be copied. See, text field. Select all, cut, paste, it's pasted. Copy, paste, Control V. See, copy, and I'll paste over here. Last time I was doing using mouse. Hello all, swing tutorial is over. Hope you understood. Please subscribe the channel. So if I select this and click on cut, then all has gone. If you edit and select on paste, then it's come now. If I select all and click on copy and then again click on paste, then again the same thing will happening over here. Yes, so in this way it's working actually. Yes, in this text area we are setting the bound, na? And in this text area we are printing it. In this text area only we are cutting or pasting or copying or selecting all. These are the methods available in text area only. These are the methods. Paste, cut is by default method. System provided methods are there. So if you just use that thing, these things will be happening in this way. So I hope that you have understood all these programs, and you can actually have a better understanding when you execute these things by your own. You have to understand that if you don't use the same code, and if you don't execute by your own hand, if you don't modify, then these things will be of no use actually. You'll get the understanding, but you'll not able to implement it by your own hand, on your own capacity. You cannot do it basically. So I'd rather always prefer that you get this program. This PDF I'll send into the description of this video. From the description of this video, you please download and then please execute these things. Get benefited from this particular class. If you find that these classes is providing value to your life and understanding in Java, then please subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much.